beyond mixing. How can we make this cauldron hotter?
Add fishnet stockings and high heels.
Wow! I don't know what's in that stuff, but it's got quite a kick.
Kind of reminds me of the bat shine my Uncle Jess used to make. I remember this one time, I brought a jar of it to a party. All I really remember is taking the first couple of sips. Then the next thing you know, it's 5 hours later, I'm in a complete stranger's belfry, I suddenly have this new tattoo, and to top it all off, my pants are missing.
This sounds like an incredibly touching story, but I'm afraid we don't have time to hear it right now. Look, Vodrick! It's boiling! It has turned bright red! It worked! It's a waterfall of fiery demonic snot.
At least it's not some other kind of demonic body fluid.
If I stuck my hand in there, I'd be pulling a stump back. That stuff is red hot.
Looks more like it's green hot to me.
It looks like the control to the walkway. The handle looks old and rusted. I wonder if it's still working. I'll see if I can lower it. The walkway isn't coming down. It looks like the controls are broken.
It's the frail remains of one of the late Baroness's prisoners.
I can't reach it from here. Considering that the vocal cords, tongue, lungs, every organ, in fact, has wasted away, I doubt we will get a response. Vodrick, help me ferry those bones to safety.
Sure, no problem. We better not try and grab them. You see how fragile they are? The moment we disturb them, they'll tumble into the demonic goo.
You're right. I guess we'll just have to find some other way to retrieve those bones. It appears to be a list containing information about the prisoner.
It's nice to know Shroudy's mother was so thorough. I'm sure it's hard to take good notes while you're busy torturing somebody. She must have been an excellent multitasker.
It says, prisoner identified as Irish tourist Shannon O'Doherty. Initially observed as member of local nunnery tourist exchange. The nuns only arrange tours for the most pious of individuals. Virginity has been confirmed. Her blood is exactly what I need to help unlock the mystery of the Book of Shrouds. That's terrible! Why would anyone need blood? It's a wooden walkway that spans a chasm.
We can't do much walking on it when it's stuck way up there.
I can't reach it from here. Excuse me, Mr. Walkway? Would you do me the courtesy of collapsing back down so we could walk across you?
Maybe you should have tried intimidating it.
There's really no point in flying up there. I wouldn't be strong enough to pull it down. It's a pair of finely crafted dragon head column supports.
I'm strong, but not that strong.
They scare me. It's a window for the dungeon.
I forgot my compass, but if I had to guess, I'd say that window faces east.
What's the point? I couldn't fly across the lake to freedom anyway. Let's try the magic acid we made on those columns. Bones the skeleton made when it collapsed. Let's just get what we need and get out of here. Ah!
Back? Stay back, I say. I don't wish to harm you, but I'll do so if you leave me no choice.
What now? Can't anything ever be easy?
It's some kind of ghost.
I'd call her a banshee. Or more specifically, a really pissed off Irish banshee.
I don't think a tender display of affection is going to resolve the problem. Hello. May I talk to you?
My name is Shannon O'Doherty. I've come from Ireland to search far and wide for my one true love.
How did you end up in Draxylvania, of all places?
I did some research into local demographics. There appeared to be a discrepancy in regards to the number of men versus the number of women in the greater Draxylvanian area. Apparently, many of the women have died over recent years due to an unusual outbreak of anemia. Interestingly enough, this same affliction seems to have taken its toll on the local paperboy population. I figured with so many men available, I was bound to find my one true love.
Were you able to find a man?
Indeed I was. Not long after I arrived here with my tour group, I received a letter at my hotel. It was addressed to me from Burgermeister Willem Vinton, Mayor of Gothford Falls. He said he was interested in meeting me after catching a glimpse of my fiery red hair.
Did you ever get to meet this Burgermeister, William Vinton?
Yes, but only briefly. He came to my hotel saying he wanted to meet me. As the mayor of Gothford Falls, he always enjoyed spending time with young ladies new to the area. I believe he took a liking to me, for he invited me to come up to his room so we could discuss Draxylvanian history.
Sounds like this Burgermeister was looking to get to know a wee bit of the Irish.
How did you end up in this castle?
A woman came to speak with our tour group, saying that she was the Baroness von Kiefer. She asked me how old I was and how it came to be that I was in Draxylvania. After I told her about myself, she offered me a job working at her castle. Since I knew that I had found my true love in Willem, I decided to stay in Draxylvania and took her up on her offer. The first night in the castle, the Baroness brought me a warm cup of tea. After taking a drink, I grew very tired, and the next thing I remember is waking up here.